Hello, in this lecture we will see bipolar junction transistor, that is BJT, and this transistor used as a switch. In BJT construction there are two types, NPN and PNP, and the different symbols of NPN transistor and PNP transistor. As we see here, there are three terminals of BJT: emitter, base and collector. Emitter and collector are of same type of doping and base is of opposite type of doping. Here also, emitter and collector are of P type of doping and base is of N type of doping. Thus, there are two types, NPN transistor and PNP transistor. The symbol is as shown. Base is shown by the straight line, and through which we are showing collector terminal and emitter terminal on both the sides. And to distinguish the type, arrow is shown from P to N. In this symbol also, we can see that emitter is P, base is N, so arrow is indicating from P to N. Thus, there is emitter, base and collector. When we are operating the BJT, there are three different configurations: common base, common emitter and common collector configurations. These three configurations have their own characteristics, but common emitter characteristics are mostly used in applications as an amplifier as well as a switch. If we see the output characteristics of this common emitter configuration, VCE is on the x-axis, IC is on the y-axis, and as base current changes, the current IC is also going to vary. When base current is zero, below that both the junctions are reverse biased and it is called as cutoff region. When base current is changing, accordingly collector current changes, this region is called as active region. Then the maximum current flows with the less voltage, this region is called as saturation region. And if the reverse bias increases beyond the limit, the breakdown of the junction takes place. That's why there is breakdown region also shown in this characteristics. As we see, there are different operating regions and applications of BJT. In this table, we can see that region of operation, the biasing of emitter base junction, the biasing of collector base junction, and what is the application of this. Cutoff region is when both the junctions are reverse biased, so it will act as open switch. Saturation region means both the junctions are forward biased, so it will carry a large current, so it is called operated as closed switch. In the active region, emitter base junction is forward biased and collector base junction is reverse biased, the transistor action takes place and it can be used in the linear amplifier application. As I have already mentioned, if the limits of the junction parameters are increased, the biasing is increased, then the breakdown region will take place. So, we are not going to operate it in breakdown region. Now, we'll see how this transistor works as a switch or inverter. So, in this, we are using common emitter configuration. Emitter is grounded. Base is connected to the input terminal through the current limiting resistor RB. Collector is connected to the VCC through the current limiting resistor RC. Output is taken from the collector terminal. So, when Vin is low, generally in the digital it is called as logic 0 and logic 1. But here for the PN junction, we are considering cut-in voltage, and for silicon it is 0.7. So, below 0.7 volt, base emitter junction is not forward biased. So, both the junctions are reverse biased, that's why it is working in cutoff region. No current will flow, and Vout is equal to VCC, that is VCE, voltage drop across the collector to emitter junction, and Vout is high. So for input 0, we are getting output high. If input is high, that is when input is connected to VCC, then base emitter junction gets forward biased. Then as this junction is getting forward biased more than 0.7 volt, it is going in saturation region. So voltage across collector to emitter terminal is very small, nearly 0.2 volt, and that's why output voltage is VCE voltage, which is very small, near to zero, and that's why Vout is equal to low. Thus, for input is equal to high, output is low. Thank you.